What's up? My name is Gyro, and we're back with some more Gotham City Impostors for the PC off of Steam. It's a free-to-play game, so if you don't got it and you want to play it, then go get Steam. And if you don't have Steam, then download that shit. I mean, who doesn't have fucking Steam if you have a computer nowadays? I mean, even Mac users have Steam and have games. I don't know if this game is available to Mac users, but I know it is to PC. And so, we're going to be playing with the Huntsman semi-auto rifle once again. I also have the Witch Doctor as my secondary. I think I'm running as the tough character, the fat man, and I have on roller skates, of course, so I can get around the map quicker as a fat man. Look at this, multi-kill coming in. I love it. I wish it would have been a little bit more. But anyways, this video is going to be just some tips and tricks that can hopefully help anybody who is just getting into this game. Now, I don't claim to be the best player at this game, but I do quite well at it, and I know what's going on for the most part, and I've experimented with a lot of the variations in the game. And I mean, there is a lot of variations that you can have with this game, and that's one thing that makes this game great and so much fun, is that there's just so much variation to everything. So tips and tricks for Gotham City Impostors is, very first thing, you got to know your maps. You got to learn these maps, and also learn, depending on what gadget you are using. Like me, I am using the skates, so you will see that there are ramps up around the map, and if I roll up over those like ramps in the corresponding direction that they're pointing, then it shoots me across the map. Now, there's also other gadgets like a grapple hook, and then also a glider wings, and those pretty much you can use with the air vents, and then also the trampolines to glide across the map in the sky. They also got like jetpacks and stuff. I mean, there's just so much variation in this game. It's pretty much like Team Fortress 2 with Batman and Jokers, except where there isn't as much customization of each of the weapons, or not like each of the weapons. I wouldn't say you can't create new like weapons pretty much like you can in Team Fortress 2. It's not that advanced, but there are a lot of like weapons and then a lot of mods that can go on the weapons. So you got to know what your gadget is for what map you're like using, and some gadgets work better on certain maps than other gadgets do, because, you know, if it's an outside map, then obviously a glider or a jetpack's gonna do quite well. But if you're playing on a map that is majorly in the inside or like indoors, then a glider or a jetpack's not gonna be all that great. So you also gotta learn where all of the health kit areas are, which are marked on the map as a green heart mini maps up in the top left, and then the plus signs that are around, those are trampolines which anybody can use, and then the ramps, I don't know what those are on the mini maps, to be honest. You guys can check it out and look, or just go play the game and check it out, you know. But okay, tip number two that I would like suggest is always get to a higher area if possible. The higher the better. If you get up on top of buildings or other high areas in the game, you will get a better view of the enemies coming along. Now, as you can notice, everything's really colorful, so it's not like you can hide and camp in the maps without people seeing you right there. So get to higher points of the map if you're playing like TDM or Bounty Hunter in the like game modes, and you will do a lot better. Also, just check out wherever your like teammates are, and if you usually stay with your teammates or by the health kit areas, then you'll usually live a lot more. Now, you need to use and choose your support item accordingly, and what that is I have the Jack-in-a-Box, which it is a explosive bomb that I throw on the ground, and then a like circle like comes up, and then if the like enemy comes into the like vicinity of that circle, it pops up and explodes, and most of the time it does a one-hit kill, and if not, you get multi-kills. What I like to do with it is put the trap-in-a-boxes on the health kit areas, like right there. You saw me just throw it down, and I like to put it like right there, and then whenever people get shot, they run towards the health kit areas and then just explode because they're already damaged, and you know, you can't heal as fast as this thing's going to kill you, because I think it does like 100 plus damage even if you are the biggest character, which there are different characters that you can be, from a little tiny girl like character or dude to a big old fat big fucking shouldered like behemoth guy. So, and it is all dependent too. The smaller the character, the faster that you will be, but the less health that you will have. The bigger the character, the more health, but the slower that you are, and all that fun stuff. Now, another tip, will find the weapons that you are comfortable with. Test, and experiment with different weapons all the time. So I think pretty much commentary is coming to the end. We won this game. Ooh, 75-34. We gave them the business. If you guys enjoyed them, be sure to click that like button below. If you thought that these tips and tricks helped you out, then be sure to comment below and tell me. If you thought that they didn't, or if there's anything that I should add, then be sure to tell me below. We'll see you next time. Later.